Hi, I'm Sherri Garron. Welcome to the Market Minute. We're joining you from Settlers Park in Hartland, where this week the Hartland Art Walk will kick off on Saturday. The August stats are in, so let's go over those and then we'll talk about this awesome event. All right, so for the stats, again, these are the August stats, and I broke them up between residential and condo because they are very different in their numbers. So if we're looking at the active listings, they were down by about 4.3% this August compared to last August. The pending sales and the closed sales were down nearly 30% since last August. So again, this is comparing last August to this August, but if we're looking at the year-to-date figures, all of them are down by about 20%, which is what we have been seeing month over month. So now for condos, again, we're looking at August of this year compared to August of last year. The active listings were down by about 21%. The pending sales were down by 46%, and the closed sales were down by 53%. Yikes, those are some big reductions. So we'll continue to monitor the condo market. Year to date, all three of these categories are down by about 23 to 25%, which is what we've been seeing month over month. So we're not sounding any alarms there, but it just wasn't a fantastic month for condos in Livingston County. Now, a couple of things we noticed, the active listings for residential homes were only down by 4.3% this August compared to last August. Most of the monthly stat reports have shown a double-digit decrease, so it was encouraging to see more active listings come on the market. When we're talking about inventory, we're hovering around 2.2 months of supply. So again, remember, anything under 6 months of supply is a seller's market, so we are well within a seller's market. So while all of the actives, the pendings, and the sales are down, things are still selling and they're selling quickly. We haven't seen a reduction in prices, and as long as that inventory remains low, those prices should really remain pretty stable. Now, when we're talking about what we're seeing in the market, last week we listed a fantastic house in a very popular neighborhood. We've had a handful of showings on it over the course of the past few days, no offers, but we know that if this would have been, say, June, we probably would have had 20 or 30 showings on it and multiple offers. We're confident we're going to get a great offer on that property or perhaps even multiple offers, but it just shows that we're starting to see that seasonal slowdown. Now back to the art walk. It takes place September 23rd through October 7th, and there will be artwork on display in both here at Settlers Park and around various businesses here in the Hartland area. So the featured artwork will be a combination of amateur and professional artists from Michigan and also a number of K through 12 students in Hartland Consolidated Schools, which I think is really awesome. And there will be links to vote on the artwork. And among the awards is students will win scholarships in various categories. So again, I think that that is just awesome. So it's been said that this is going to hopefully be similar to like the Grand Rapids Art Prize. And the kickoff is going to take place on the 23rd here at Settlers Park. And there will be live music and food trucks, vendors, a scavenger hunt, and all the fun things you would come to expect with a kickoff celebration like this. So you can find further details on this awesome event at heartlandliving.com. We hope we can see you out here and check out and support some new and upcoming artists. And as always, if you have any questions about your specific real estate needs, we'd be happy to have a conversation. Take care.